Today we're going to be looking at GarageBand to create a ringtone. Up first, GarageBand makes it very easy to create a ringtone. It's a new feature that's on there. So over on the side here, these are all my recent projects that I have so far. Off to the side though, they have an iPhone ringtone now. I can go ahead and click on that, and that's where we'll begin our project today. Well, there's a lot of different things in here. The example ringtone is pretty easy to use because it has it all set up for you. If you click on the loops one, it has the same exact things available that the example one does. It just doesn't have the stuff in there. So we go with the example ringtone. I'm going to go ahead and save the song just like we did the other days here. I'm just going to entitle this ringtone for now because I'm going to end up changing it after I export it to iTunes. Alright, here is the example clip. This is the one that they put in here already from GarageBand. You can see that this is one of the loops that was in GarageBand originally. We're going to go ahead and take that one out of there, and we're going to put in our own loop. Now, for this project, you're going to create two ringtones. One of them you have to create using the Apple loops that are on GarageBand. The second ringtone that you're going to create actually is going to be created from an MP3. A lot of people love popular songs for ringtones, and that tends to work out better because they're more familiar, they're more updated, and you can still personalize them to some degree. So now we're going to go ahead and drag GarageBand off the side here, and we're going to go get ourselves an MP3. We don't have one with us on hand, so we're going to grab one really quick here. I'm going to show you how to do that. Now we're going to go over to Safari or Google, it doesn't matter. And once we're here, we're going to just go to YouTube. Alright, now I'm at YouTube here, and I've typed in Rage Against the Machine, Bulls on Parade. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to get this song off of here. Any of the songs that have pre-made videos for them tend to work really well. Most of you probably already know this process, but what I'm going to do is I'm on the video link here, the actual page that has the video, which is important. And up at the top here, I'm going to copy the URL. Once I've copied the URL, I'm going to go to a new site. I'm going to go ahead and open up a new tab here. And on this new site, what I'm going to do is type in www.youtube-mp3.org. Alright, now this is the site that's going to take my YouTube video and actually convert it to an MP3. So I'm going to go ahead and get rid of the pre-made loop or the pre-made link that's in there. And I'm going to paste in my own. So I'm going to just hit Command V to paste that in there, and then I'm going to convert the video. And go ahead and click Download. Now it's going to put it into your downloads down here. Once that's done, it'll actually kick up iTunes here and start playing the song for you. So go ahead and pause that. Alright, now we want to get the MP3 actually into GarageBand, so I'm going to go back to my downloads. I'm going to find the Rage Against Machine clip, and I'm going to go ahead and drag that MP3 right into GarageBand. It's going to convert it, normalize it, do a bunch of stuff to it, make it so that I can edit it actually. Drag that over to the beginning, go ahead and give this a listen. Alright, that beginning part I probably don't want, so I'm going to go ahead and cut that out of there. So I'm going to go ahead and use Command-T to trim the clip. Okay, deselect it and select the part I want to get rid of. And then I'm going to delete that out of there and move that over. Now that's the beginning part of the clip that I want to use for my ringtone. Ringtones can range anywhere from 15 to 30 seconds. That's what most phones are set up with. Some will play full songs, but again, it eats up a lot of memory for your ringtone. I'm going to stretch this out a little bit longer here. Now I want a little bit more of this clip here. It doesn't quite get up to the part that I want. So the yellow line indicates the part where the ringtone is going to happen. So I'm going to stretch that out for the part that I want and go ahead and preview that to see if it is. Yep, indeed, that's the part that I want. Okay. Now I want to cut that clip off. Now wherever the yellow ends is actually where the ringtone's going to end, but if you just want to be certain that there isn't any extra file on there, you can go ahead and shrink this down to size. So I go ahead and expand this out so that I can see the full song. Now I'm going to just grab the bottom right corner and I'm going to drag it back to pretty close to the yellow mark here. I'm going to stretch it back out so I can do my editing. Okay, now I grab the lower right corner again, drag it back so that it's even with yellow. And the little waved amplitudes are where the voice comes in. I'm going to go ahead and get rid of that. Okay, so now at this point, I'm ready to export to iTunes here. I've got my ringtone all set up. We're going to do this much in the same way as we did yesterday. We go to Share. Instead of going to Export Song to Disk, though, we're going to go to Send Ringtone to iTunes. It's going to mix it down just like it did yesterday with our songs. And it brings up iTunes right away. All right, now that the song is in iTunes here, I can see it in my playlist. I can see it at the top. And the big question is over on my playlist, though, I don't really see the song over there because this is the music list. So if I want to change that name from ringtone to something else that I can identify, I got to change it from music to tones. Now, in the tones, I can see the file. I can click on it. Now I'll be able to actually change to what I want. I call this Rage Ringtone. Okay, and that's just a good way to keep your clips organized here. Now, I've got the tones, I've got my music. If I want to find the actual file, though, I can go ahead and right-click on this. And what's going to happen is I can go Show in Finder. And there's the actual file. So I can email this to myself, put it on Google Drive, save it on a flash drive, and then later at home where I've got my phone synced up, I can go ahead and put it on there. And I hope you enjoyed our tutorial for today.